Alright, what is up, ladies and gentlemen? It's VMP. Welcome back. This time we're here with a little more Viking Conquest. And I think that today might just be the big day. Supposedly, right here in Readingham, we are going to run into Sven Bull Neck and hopefully finish him off once and for all and rescue our mother. I don't know how this goes. I think this might be the end of the campaign. So we'll see. Only one way to find out. Let's do this. Mercenary Archer. Enemy lookouts watch you closely from the walls of Readingham. The site has good defenses and moat, and there are still remnants of the previous battle when the Saxons tried to expel the Danish. It is a good position to defend. You notice that a group of men approaching you. Yeah, that doesn't make sense. Not grammatical sense, that's fine. It is led by a tall man. This must be Edric, the man mentioned by Aelfrid. Okay. Kraus and Firebrand. My lord advised me that you'd come. Sven Bull Neck has taken Readingham and has many men with him, mainly Danish, who have sworn allegiance. They are tough, battle-hardened people, same as Sven, who is a legend. I would not like to be in the shoes of you or your men. Let's ask him if our mother's with him. You mean your mother, the satyr, right? Yes, she is with them. Okay, good, good. We saw her when she entered Readingham with Sven Bull Neck. I do not know how she was before, but now she is very gaunt and thin. I do not think she has long to live. We gained 147 renown, holy shit. Well, from what I've heard, you're also something dangerous. I would leave 50 men. I promised my lord I would. They are brave warriors who have promised a lot of gold, or who have been promised a lot of gold to help you, so fight well. Farewell, Carlson Firebrand, and good luck. Okay, let's do this. So do we get to bring in our own army? Because I did recruit a few guys in between that, so not a ton, you know, like about 10 or so. Just to replenish some of the guys that we lost in that big battle. The site has good defenses and moat. And there are still remnants of the previous battle when this... Okay, just, we already read that. Get closer. Okay, this is just me. I mean, we don't need other guys. I just thought that we would have them. Can't pull up the minimap. Okay, so I'm not sure if this is a real battle. If we're just, like, scouting them or something. Okay, up there are some people up there. Are we supposed to kill them? I guess we'll see once we get closer if our, directional keys light up. Sven shouts, "Ha! I knew you would come, Carlson Firebrand. You and me have unfinished business that must be concluded. The blood of my brother Olvir still stains your hands. Thanks to you, I had to turn against my lord Sigurd, kill Harald, and become a masterless man. But now I'm strong. Many men follow me. You and you alone are the cause of your ruin, Sven. You should have never attacked the Odin Rick. Now free my mother and let's settle this between you and me." Oh, look how badass we look, by the way. Okay, there we go. "I think not. She is my wife and my satyr. If you want her, come get her, but have a care. You might find my sword instead." Is that our mother? Wow, she is really not looking so hot right now. Oh, man. Okay, even if we, like... Okay, I'm kind of worried, because even if we do get her... Your mother looks tired and withered. She says, "My little one, I see your face and I remember. I regret everything you've had to do for my sake. Go and live your life. I die soon. Sven is a murderer and a madman. Do not give me the satisfaction, do not give him the satisfaction of killing you." "Shut up, woman. You see your little one has decided to die. Carlson Firebrand, here I wait. Come and get me if you dare. My brother Olvir will glad when I send you to the halls of hell." Oh, bitch. You don't know who you're messing with. You really don't know. Let's do this. Okay, so he's actually going to let us duel him? Oh, no. Okay, so we are... No, here's where we get our men. All right, boys. Follow me for right now. How much we got here? 113, he has 125. Oh, they're attacking us from behind. Hold position, men! Charge him, bitches! Let's fuck him up. All right, we need to get on the outside of this little group here, if we can. Oh, knocked him to the ground, dead. Another one. Now we're not actually killing some of these guys. We're just, you know, crippling them for life before we kill them and finish them off. It is still crippling them for life when they only have another 5 seconds to live. Oh, there goes a decapitation. That's what I'm talking about, baby. There we go. Alright. Charge. Come on, boys. I really don't care too much about our men here. Because a lot of these aren't even ours. I just want Sven at this point. Get out of here. Where is he at, by the way? Where's that coward? I have a feeling we might have to duel him at the end. I want to duel him at the end. I don't want a random troop to get that kill on Sven. That is mine. He is mine. Who is that? Nope, Danish Elite Viking. Just making sure none of these guys are Sven here. Alright, they got a lot of javelin throwers. That's our one weakness. But right now, we're still at basically full health. They haven't really hit us at all. Fuck off. Miss me with that spear. Ooh, someone's behind. Block you. That's a one. That's a two. Ooh, picked up that javelin. Didn't even see it coming. I was kind of lucky. Oh, they're running, man. They're running for the hills. Oh, lose your head, baby. Lose your head. There you go. You guys finish him off. He's almost dead already. They just have a few guys trickling in. Boom! Did we just... Oh, I thought we decapitated him, too. That would have been our sickest kill yet. Oh, almost got him. Oh, that actually didn't do a lot of damage at all. It looked cool. Jumped forward, stabbed him in the throat, but didn't actually do anything to him. Right in the knee. Want to do it again? Down you go. All right, here we go. Was Dan in this fight, by the way? I didn't see Dan. Didn't see him if he was. Okay, there's two guys left. They're just running away. We're basically... Oh, yeah, we stomped them, baby. We only lost 15 dudes. That's not bad at all. Come on, get out of here, boys. Oh, shit, we have hops. Oh, my God, did you just see that jump? Carlson just cleared, like, 10... Well, a lot more than 10 people, but probably, like, 6 or 7 in a row. New enemies arrive. All right. The slaughter continues in Reedingham. Your men still fighting against the remnants of Sven's troops, but that is not the battle you seek. Of course it isn't. Sven Bull Neck has barricaded himself in the Mead Hall of Reedingham, taking your mother and the few men with him. It's time to end this party. Oh, baby, you're running away now. You're running away. You fool. Is this what you wanted? Do you think you can still win? I'm still alive. And as I warned you, she is dead. Your mother speaks. My little one, I love you. Remember that your mother has always loved you and will watch you from wherever I go. You motherfucker. Sven, I swear to... Baby. Oh, no, baby. Get the fuck out of here. Where is... Boom! Sven Bull Neck. Knocked unconscious. No, I want him dead. I want him dead. His men can die right away. Guess he'll have to wait. We'll get to torture him a little bit, maybe. Make sure that when he dies in combat, he doesn't have his weapon. He doesn't go to Valhalla. He gets the goddamn Blood Eagle. Ooh, what is this? Blinderbruder. That's his weapon, huh? Whew. Sven Bull Neck finally lies dead. You have accomplished your revenge, but you are left with a bitter taste in your mouth because of your mother's dead body is lying not far from Sven's. The woman who raised you, for her, you left everything behind to seek a healer and freeze. Her last words of love resonate in your mind, like a distant echo. Sven Bull Neck and your mother have been the energy that has driven you so far, but both are now dead. You feel a void, as if part of you went with them. After everything that happened, all you have left are memories. Hold a funeral. Mom. Oh, I mean, you kind of had to expect that it was going to happen, right? There's no way Sven was going to let us just take her. I wish there had just been something we could have done to stop her from dying. You should go down to your mother and drop off something she can use on her way to Valhalla. Okay. I don't want to give my sword up. This is really selfish. I don't know why I'm saying that. Mom. Oh, whoops, go over here. This is actually a really cool little thing. Hint, drop something in the ship. Oh, no, I don't want to drop the shield. I guess we'll drop the bow. Dropping strong longbow. Beta Chronicle. My name is Beta, and this book started as a chronicle of a dark time, but the time is not so dreadful as it was overshadowed by a hero. I was there when the armies of the Saxons and Danes fought at Ascendon. I was there when Carlson Firebrand changed the course of history. But even this, and what happened next, pales in importance when the world lost its hero. I remember it like it just happened, when we entered the hall and watched as Sven Bull Neck finished off Carlson Firebrand's mother. I remember his face. It became ice cold. Neither anger, nor fear, nor crying. Only coldness. I assure you that Sven Bull Neck turned pale because he knew that his death was inevitable. We fought in the hall and Sven died, but that did not change the hardness of the face of Carlson Firebrand. Neither then, nor later, at the funeral of his mother, revered like a queen, buried with rich grave goods in a warship. After that day, we lost our hero. He said farewell to us. who we had followed him from battle to battle, and said he was leaving without revealing his destination. He left us, I fear, never to return. I hope I am wrong, because this dark world still stands in need of his exploits. After the departure of our leader, we, his followers, dispersed to the four winds. I hid in a monastery in a remote part of West Seax, far from it. Here I will wait for the end of my days. I pay people to bring me news from outside, especially if they find Carlson Firebrand, but nobody has seen him. However, I have a little news from others who were with him until the end. Little news has reached me about young Cao. I do not know for sure that he never returned to Hadrian's Wall, not even to visit his family. Last I heard is that he embarked on a Danish expedition headed towards Constantinopolis. Brunhild married a Dane, despite having always hated them, and settled near Jorvik. A merchant told me that she is currently a happy mother with three children. The fate of Donchad was dark. He returned to Alban, where he recruited a crew of Scots to pillage the Norwegian merchants in the Sea of Hibernia. The Norwegians of Dublin put a price on his head and gave chase and killed him in an epic battle that the bards still sing about at the court of Alban. The Greek Agathinos stayed in the north, near Lundenwick. There he got a job rebuilding the old Roman infrastructure. Sometimes I get letters from him. I do not know why we were never friends, but he likes to keep up the relations he made in his past, and I must be the only remnant of another time that he left. And that is all I know about the people who served under Carlson Firebrand. I hope my writings serve to keep Carlson Firebrand in history. A man who started from nothing on a ship called the Odin Rick, rose to be a warlord who was able to put in check the powers of his time. He it was who killed the dreaded Sven Bull Neck, and could be measured face to face with the most powerful men like the sons of Ragnar and the kings of West Seax. May the world remember Carlson Firebrand when the rest of us have all perished. Holy shit, that was badass. Is it done? I mean, the campaign's done. Is the, is our save over? I guess we'll find out after the credits here. That was... Guys, I really enjoyed that. I know you that seems a little redundant to say that, but like seriously, that was so worth the $2 or $3 I spent on this DLC. This was very well made. I wish more mods were like this. I wish they would make more even DLC like this. That was incredibly well done. Holy shit. To have a campaign and a storyline that in the setting of Mountain Blade, that is just perfect. Alright, how long is this thing? I mean, I don't want to cut it short, and... Okay, it looks like we're getting to the end here. I don't want to cut it short, because these guys did an excellent job, they deserve their recognition. But at the same time, I'm kind of eager to know is our campaign done, or can we continue it? Because I don't want to be done. If it is done, I'll probably just reload the save, and then we'll never... Go to sandbox mode? Yes. Okay, there we go. Boom, quest completed. We're done. We did it. And we still got our heroes. Awesome. Okay. All right. So we didn't actually end up losing anybody. Well, guys, there we go. That is the end of the campaign, the story mode. Like I said, that was a blast. It was so much fun. Oh, hello. What? What just happened? We just got a quest? What's going on? Oh, okay. It's just, I was just reporting to him. He's in Wilton. We're still at war with everybody. We can say that Sven Bull Neck is successfully dead, and the rest of them are gone, but the Danish forces are still somehow still around, even though we killed, 1,200 or something of them. Alright, let's see if we can't find... Oh, great, he's not nearby, is he? Oh, here we go, choose a goal! A new world full of adventure awaits you. If this is your first time playing Viking Conquest Sandbox, then check out the Set of Gold presentation to learn more about the game and to see what you can do next. Okay, continue. Create a new goal. Infamous raider, famous warrior, powerful lord, strong king, stable kingdom. Let's go, famous warrior. Oh. Powerful lord. Okay. What do we get when we get these? Okay, so let's say 150 army size. Okay, that's fine. Reputation, 100, because we're already there. Renown, let's push for like 700. Renown's kind of difficult to get in this mod. So we'll say like, I think 700 is a good number. Right to rule, say like 15. Seems good to me. And wealth, let's do 30,000. That looks good to me. Boom. Okay. Alright. The common life is not for you. You wish to become a nobleman, lead great armies, and to be known as a lord and master of your own lands. Alright. Better troops are also more expensive to train. Try to keep form an army with 25% heavies, her high level units. Okay. Cool. Boom. I don't know what we get if we complete that goal, if that's just, like, not really all that important, but I guess we can try to do that. Where are we right now in terms of all that? Let's see. Oh, shit, we have 949 renown. We're actually already there. So we just need, we have 16 right to rule. We actually just need the money right now, I think. And 150 troops. We're not there yet. That's actually not too bad. Look at this. Holy shit, 2,100 enemies killed. Jesus Christ. That's a lot, man. I mean, it's nothing on, like, you know, our other series, like, you know, Prophecy of Pandora, where we had 40,000. But, you know, relative... Oh, hello. Oh, quest canceled, just as we got to him. How nice. Okay, so, while we're here, let's go ahead and sell off all this loot that I got in between episodes, fighting a few, random groups of bandits. And then, do we have any meat? We need to be feeding our boy Dan. Because from what you guys said, you can continue to... You only have 220... Broke-ass motherfucker. What the hell? For real? Alright, man. Oh, the horses can't afford it either. Okay, armor guy can afford it. There we go. That's better. But yeah, so you can keep on feeding Dan, our dog. I'm gonna call him... I mean, his name's Dan, so hopefully you guys realize that I'm not talking about actual Dan. But, yeah, you can keep on feeding him, and he keeps on getting stronger and faster and better. So we're definitely going to keep on doing that, and hopefully by the end he's actually going to be pretty tanky. We'll see. Otherwise, it'll just be kind of a side mission for... Holy shit, look at all this. Oh, baby. Oh, baby. We're going to be able to feed him for a long time. Buying all this, I mean, that's kind of a lot of money right now. 2 grand? Fuck it. He's worth it. He's worth it. Stroll around town. I'm not sure what we can actually feed him and what we can't. Oh, we can feed him all of this. Okay. Here we go. You don't look healthy. Here, have some sausages. This beef will make you stronger. Oh, we can just keep on feeding him. Oh, sweet. I thought you could only do it, like, once a day. Holy shit. Okay. He's about to be... He's about to be wrecking fools. I mean, probably not yet. But he's getting there. He's gonna get there. Okay, so who are we at war with right now? We still at war, so Merse, we got Kingdom Northumber, still at war with them. They just have this one town over here? No, they got this one over here, too. And so we're the Lord of Dinbic, right? Right? I'm trying to remember. It's been a little while. Yeah, so we're the Lord of Dinbic and Trefbic. So, I mean, it would be nice to get another castle, but what I'm really after is a town. And so this town was relatively recently... taken out, so maybe let's go over there and scout it out. I'm not saying that we got enough to take it on right now, but you never know. Maybe we're almost okay. Hello. By now you have some experience with Viking Conquest. If this is your first game, we recommend making yourself familiar with some of the game concepts. You'll be directed to a page that presents them now. Okay, what is this? Leadership, increase the maximum size of your army by 5. Okay, charisma, maximum size by 1. Renown, every 9 points increases the maximum size by 1. Okay. Holdings. Ooh, every town will add 80 men, and each fort will add 40 men to the maximum size of your levy. Oh, that's actually cool. Okay. Wow, there's actually a lot of shit over here, huh? Dog companion. Ooh. The skills and abilities of your dog companion can be improved by giving him food. Okay. That's kind of what we already knew. Courtship. We still need to work on that. Character backgrounds. Okay. I think for the most part we're pretty good here. Okay. Ooh, actually, hello. Higher looting skill results in a higher chance of capturing enemy ships. That's kind of neat to know. Alright, let's check out Lunwick here. What do we got? What are you talking about? 773. Okay. We're not quite there yet. That's a little bit beyond our ability. Let's see if we can't maybe find, like, a small lord running around. Are we just at war with them, or are we at war with other people as well? War with Northumber and Cornubia. Which one's Cornubia? Oh, these guys. Oh, these guys are scrubs. I bet you. I bet you these guys. Oh, and Bosvenna just got taken over there as well. Bet you guys that these guys will have some people for us to take on. You guys aren't worth our time. Oh, shit. Okay, hello. Hello. 4 grand a week. Okay, our wages are kind of getting up there. I guess we do have an army of 100 that we're hauling around right now. We're going to have to make some more money at some point. Ooh, Danish Longfort. That's actually a good way to make money. We might do that in a sec, but I want to scout out over here to see what kind of lords are running around here. Boss Vanilla, what you got? What you got? Oh, here we go. Here we go, baby. 136? That's it? Easy money. Easy money. Okay, 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 okay. Here we go. Planning siege. So, first thing, we want to order construction of sanitation. Do that right now. Also, we want to... Blockade? No. Investigate defenses? No. Build mantlets. Okay, this is what we want. So, the mistake I made last time is when we just charge in without building mantlets. That's when we take a bunch of casualties setting up the ladders. Supposedly doing this will make it so that we won't have to do that. Okay, so now let's wait for a little bit. So we need to wait 14 hours for all that to be done. No blockade. I don't think the mantlets are done already, so we're going to wait a little bit. Just make sure that those are done. Make sure that those are done. What the fuck? What happened? So we lost 4 dudes, huh? That's stupid. I mean, they lost some guys too, so I can't complain too much. Alright, so we'll do it after this one. Boom. I think we should be ready to go. Mantlets are ready? Yep, your men have finished building the mantlets. You can use them to protect your soldiers in the vanguard attack and your main force for the final charge. Alright, let's do it. 14 hours. In the morning. Actually, we might not even have to wait for the morning. It'll be close. It'll be close. We can just go right on in. They have 36 prisoners here, so we actually will be able to recruit some dudes back as well. We ready? Place the mantlets, so we only lost 4 this time. Okay, that's a whole lot better than like 20-some like we lost last time. Who did we lose? Oh no, we lost our Norse companion! Oh no, 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 that's fine. I was thinking Norse bodyguard. We're good, we're good. Because we did get a second Norse bodyguard. I'm not sure if he's still alive, but I think he is. If he is, his name is going to be Parsonag, because that's what one of you guys named him. Alright, boys. Let's do this. We fought much tougher. Nope. I thought I could press F4 and it would... No? Is that not the case? I thought I could press F4 and that would show me different options. Okay, well, I guess not. I guess not. I guess we're just going straight in. Oh, we still have our bow. Okay, I thought we had actually lost that. Guess not. They tried shooting us. Just bounced right off my iron flesh. I see that little guy. Oh, we got a lot of... This is actually pretty far away. Jesus Christ. These are some long-range shots. What was that? Was that our Norse bodyguard? Hit him again. Oh, we're not doing a lot of damage here. Do you do less damage with the bow the farther away they are? Is that a thing? They're running out of the castle at us. Their archers are running away from the protection of the walls directly towards us. Okay, I am fine with this. Please, continue. Tell me more about your advanced tactics. Oh shit, we are just whiffing these arrow shots. What the hell? There we go, that's one. That's two, you're dead. Saxon bodyguards. Oh, these guys are actually pretty good. Okay, boys, let's head in a little bit closer. Oh, those are the mantlets they're talking about, I think. Pretty sure they're not talking about those houses. We didn't just put those up overnight. Okay, that's a lot of javelins they're throwing our way. I don't know if we really wanna... Oh, are they done with their javelins already? Okay, that was actually... We didn't lose anybody. I wanna take out some of these dudes just because they're just way out in the open. Make it a lot easier. They're not really doing any damage. Might as well just take them out now. Can't really take out any of the dudes with shields for the time being, but that's fine. Ooh, ouch. Oh, 3 damage, it's not too bad. Oh, fuck, I saw that javelin coming. Ouch, that hurt. Alright, boys, it's time. Let's go. Archers, stay put over here. I don't think we really had many archers, but that's fine. Alright, I'm jumping on this one. Let's get right on in this bitch. Can we go through the front gate? Is that a thing? Not sure if it is or not. Hello, fuckers. Oh, can knock to your feet, baby. Get out of here. Get out of here. Oh, that dude's throwing punches. I literally saw one of them throwing punches. Yeah, spoiler alert, I can take swords and not be really all that troubled by them. Your fists, unless you're goddamn Rocky himself, aren't gonna do anything to me. There we go. There we go. We're in a good position. We're in a good position. We're just cutting them down to pieces. To pieces. Ooh, I see a Norse bodyguard. Oh, that's one of ours. That's our Norse bodyguard. That is that Parsonog? It might be. Yeah, I think that's Parsonog right there. That's the new boy. All right, these guys are turned around. Perfect position for me to just cut them up from behind. Notice, I used to say stuff like destroy them from behind until I realized how kind of, you know, homosexual that sounded. That's actually a long time ago. I used to say that a bunch. You guys would always call me out on it. It was kind of an inside joke, so I'd keep on saying it. Boom! Oh, no. Every time I do that, I want someone to get decapitated just because it'd be so sweet to just jump at them and cut his head off in mid-flight. All right, here we go. 88 plus 28. Oh, they've only got 10 left. That's it. GG. This was easy. Easiest way to get a town. And you guys told me. You guys told me, VMP, watch out. This series is going to take a long time. It's going to take you like 100-something episodes to conquer the map. Wrong. Wrong. I'm determined that it will not take me 100 episodes. I don't care if I have to... Are they, like, up here? I don't care. If we get to, like, 90-something episodes and we're not anywhere close, I'm making, like, 4-hour episodes just so that we do it. I'm determined. Got another boy up here somewhere? How the fuck are we supposed to get to these guys, by the way? Oh. That makes sense. Hey, good battle. Nice and easy. Just the way I like it. We only lost 3 troops. A Viking and 2 Saxon veterans. Not bad at all. Not bad at all. And we're going to pick up a couple of Angle nobles. Some Angle warriors. Hell yeah. I mean, we're going to take all of them just so we can station here. We can have up to 52 prisoners. Come to Papa. Come to Papa. I finally know how to sell you prisoners off to bands of young warriors. All right, share the loot as is common. Oh, yeah, here we go. Here we go. So I think we need the... I think the sausages is just how you heal him, is how you heal your dog. Not 100%, though. Not 100%. This will be worth a decent amount of cash. And hopefully the town will give us a lot of income. All right, so the battle for Bosvina is almost over. Your troops are eager to start plundering the town. The poverty of the town of Bosvina is unbearable. Well, we want to conquer, I think we want to conquer and plunder, right? I mean, it's already unbearable poverty, so it's not like they can really get that much more poor. So let's conquer and, plunder. There we go. Oh, shit, do we have to kill the inhabitants now? Oh, shit. Oh, whoa, hello, we're on a horse. Oh, boy. Wait, can we do that glitch where you can walk backwards up a mountain with your horse? Oh, yes, we can. If you guys haven't seen that before, that's really fun. Get me in here, baby. Get me in here. Oh, man. Okay, now I kind of feel bad about this. Oh, we're just killing the... Oh, we're killing the townsmen. Did we... Maybe we didn't have to do this. This is just cruel and unusual punishment. Look at these moats, man. I mean, they don't have any water in them, but those are some big-ass trenches. I mean, I guess trenches that big kind of, like, serve the purpose. You can't really just climb out of there easily, unless you have a magical horse like ours that can just fucking moonwalk back up the side with no problem. Seriously, that's so... it's so stupid, but it's funny at the same time. Got any people over here that you're fighting? Any townsmen I can help you slaughter? We're losing our reputation when we do this, but that's fine. We'll know in the future. Don't kill the townsmen. We'll probably just lose morale with our troops or whatnot, but that's fine. After a great victory like this, our morale is plenty high enough. We almost done? How many more innocents do we have to kill? Like, seriously, why are we killing the inhabitants? We wanna own this place. I literally just wanted their belongings. Oh, shit, nice victory. Cool little cinematic shot they got there, too. Very nice, very nice. Ooh, some more sausages to heal up our... Wow, we didn't even get anything good out of this. Okay, yeah, we're definitely not doing that shit in the future. me, a little bit of this, a little bit of that. Good enough. Boom. And I want that rewarded to us. 500. 500. Wow. So the town is just destroyed? Question mark? Wow. Yeah, it is. It's all kinds of fucked up. Okay. So we're going to station a bunch of our boys in here. How many of these boys do we want to put in here? I'm liking these guys right now. I think just kind of maybe some of our weaker dudes. Some of our weaker guys for the time being. Oh, we leveled up. Nice. So we're down to 88. I think that, I mean, that's fine. That's a good enough number. So leave that in there. That's how much? 30? Okay, it's not a lot. In fact, we might just want to... Yeah, my bad. I won't do it again. I won't do it again. Don't you worry. What do we got over here? Ooh, 584. Okay, not going to take them on. What about, 128? Hello, actually. Actually, I might try to fight you and get an epic trophy so that I can redeem it for some money, because trust me, your boy still needs some money. Actually, we need to sell off what we have right now before we start fighting more lords. So I guess we can go to the ferry station and sell them off. I don't want to go all the way. Yeah, I guess we'll just go to the ferry station. Then we can take our boat over there if we have to. Actually, no, we can't take our boats. We don't have enough space. Oh, those villagers just ran way the hell out of their path to get away from us. We weren't even looking at them. We weren't even bothering with them. There we go. 88 pennings. Better bring your whole family out to row my army across. There's quite a few of us. There we go. Okay, looks like those guys are going over there, so... ooh! They're suggesting that we get named as Marshal. I don't think I've ever had that happen in any of our campaigns. We never played with a... Alright, here we go. It's between us and Elderman Kuthred. Drithwad, okay, don't even know who you are. It's one for us. Geralf went for him. Sigbert Sigwolfing, okay, don't know you either. Wigstan went for him. Wolfred went for him. Buka went for him. Aelfstain, Wolfier, Aethelmod. Ooh. Aelfred! What the hell, man? We're best friends! Fine. Next time. If there is a next time, we'll see. Okay, trade with the locals. Do you got some money? I'm gonna need you to have a lot of money. We got a lot of loot here. There we go. Do they have enough? Is the question. Maybe. No, they don't. Okay, they're pretty close, though. I'll tell you what, we might buy the dried meat and the beef and the chicken, just so we can give that to our boy Dan. How much is the rest of this worth? Boom, boom. I guess we'll keep the rest of this, just for morale. Just for morale's sake, we can keep the rest of this. Wow, we have a lot of stuff right now. We have a lot of food. I guess we're kind of traveling around with a bigger army than we normally do, so that's fine. Move this up. Just because I'm OCD and like things to be neat. There we go. Perfect. Let us... How much money? So we got 3,500. So we still... Getting money is kind of difficult in this mod. Like, it's not impossible, but it's just not easy either. It's annoying. It's constantly going to be something that we're going to have to worry about. All right, baby. Give some more beef, make you stronger. Some beef faster. Here's some chicken and some dried meat for your teeth. All right. That's all for today. Thank you. And go, Dan, go. Run, Forest, run. All right. Very nice. Very nice indeed. So, we could use running into another band of free warriors. That'd be nice. Just because we have 29 prisoners to sell off. I did sell off that massive prisoner party that we had in between episodes. And actually netted a decent amount of money. Like, probably about a grand, maybe. Probably not even a grand. But it was like, it's a lot better than the, like, 5 dinars a person we were getting beforehand. So, I can't complain too much. Let's take out this Danish longfort. Actually, I might do that in between episodes, just because those battles actually take a while and they're not that exciting. Okay, this dude's trying to besiege our town. I don't think so. Oh, you're running away? You're running away? Too bad. Okay, now he wants to fight me. Yeah, I'm gonna have to ask you to surrender or die. Oh, wow, we lost a lot of relationship with him. He's not happy about that. Come on, you even outnumber us. It's fair. It's a fair battle. Okay, we'll have our boys stay back for right now, just for right now. Oh, here we go. Oh, so here's how you get the complex formations, ranks, with best troops up front. Shield wall, shields in front, wedge, best troops up front, square. What do we want here? Ranks with best troops up front? Kinda. I'd rather have a shield wall. Boom. There we go. Not enough troops in Division 9, Dan, to form a wall. Dan, charge. I like how he has his own division. The Dan Division. Okay, they do have a few horsemen. Not that we're afraid of them by any means. We'll duel them any day. He's starting a shield taunt. Where's he at? Where's that boy at that's starting a shield taunt? Oh, he's over here. Oh, you're not by your men. I don't know why they always run away from their men. Ooh, okay. I got a little nervous because he was trying to hit us. And he does outrange us with his spear a little bit. Fuck up his horse, fuck up your horse, and fuck your life up. There we go. The morale's already fading. Let's get their other horse. Oh, they got a couple more horsemen. I'm going to take them out just because. Come here. Hey, come here. Oh, fuck. I'm so close. Fuck off. We're actually kind of hurting our horse here. You want to be a little careful. A little careful. Oop, oop, oop. Duck. Dodge. Weave. Oh, shit. There goes our horse. Okay. Luckily, we got this guy here. Hey, you. Hey, you. Oh, damn it. We hit his horse. It's not what we want. Oh, Dan got knocked unconscious. Where's everybody else at? All right. We can tell our boys to charge in now. Whoops. Not just Dan. Everybody. Yeah, VMP move. Oh, there we go. Perfect. Pony. Nice to make your acquaintance. All right, let's track down these random couple of straggling units that they got over here. How's our shield wall looking? What does this look like? It's not really as packed together as I would want. Can I tell them to stand closer? Yeah, here we go. I want you guys looking like a Roman legion. Everybody together, advance, march, fuck them up. Oh, hello. Wow, they are devoting entire divisions of men towards me. Finally, we're getting the respect we deserve. Or maybe these guys are just running away. One of the two. But regardless, our boys are going to come in and mess them up. So. This guy actually had a decent amount of troops here. Let's try to break them up as best that we can, so that this shield wall is not doing too much for them. I want our shield wall to be working, not theirs. Okay, oh, we're just cutting them to pieces. There we go. We surrounded them. We've got them flanked. It's over. Oh, man. I can't even get kills here. Our boys are taking them out too fast. Holy shit. Oh, that was one of their dudes. I was like, who do we have that has a weapon that's like 3 times as tall as his body? I need to know this man. Is that Parsonag? Is that our new Norse bodyguard? Oh, there we go. Right in the back. Right in his back. Alright, we're done. Nope. Not done. Come on, finish him off. There's only 16 of them left. I guess that's a decent amount. Not quite finished yet. Phew, that was a real good battle. Only lost 2 dudes? Is our surgery skill just that great? It's only losing 2 dudes when we had 10 guys get knocked unconscious. I feel like that's pretty good odds unless some of those dudes were heroes. But even then, we don't have that many heroes left anymore. So many of them, like, we had to kill Reigenhard. We killed Eagle. I forgot. Arrow shot's really slow in this game. Hit him once, but I'm not going to hit him again. We good? We gotta be good by now. No, Jesus, come on, man. This shit's over. This battle is over, I promise. Wow, we lost 2 more guys right at the end. We doubled our losses at the end somehow when they were fleeing. And there were 2 good units. It was like an elite Viking and a regular Viking. What's going on? How are those guys the one that die? There we go. Okay, we're good. We're good. We gained 14 renown. Damn right we do. Damn right we do indeed. Alright, we got a war trophy. You know what? We're honorable now. You're free to go. One thing to note, though, apparently we don't get as much relationship, though. We still get 5 relationship for setting them free, but you gain -10 relationship when you attack them. So, oh shit, I didn't even mean to do that. Because I don't even think this loot's going to be all that great, low-key, but whatever. Oh, shit, they lost a bunch of morale. Fuck. Still high. Still high, though, so we're good. Oh, yeah, Bossman, I got fucking destroyed. Oh, shit, okay, that might take them a while to get back, huh? Is that... Am I understanding this right? Ooh, hello, people are joining the Kingdom of Northumber? That's not good. Alright, how long is it going to take for Bossman to get... Can we look that up in, like, the notes page? Will it tell us? Where is that at? I think, was it quarters, actually? Nope. I'm not sure. Second outfit? No. Huh. Yeah, I'm not actually sure. It's gotta be notes, right? Game concepts. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Siege. Siege warfare. Okay. No, this doesn't talk about after siege. Oh, well. Oh, well. I assume they'll be back at some point. I mean, we didn't completely destroy it. We only chose the second worst option out of all of them. There were two worse ones than the one we did. All right, here we go. We'll just get across real quick. If they retake it, so be it. We can retake it again. And hopefully then it won't be absolutely in ruins. We'll have to see, though. But for right now, we'll just go over here. We will... what do we got? Traded locals, redeem battle trophy, boom, 1,000 pennings, just like that, nice and easy. They don't have money. They have some money. Here we go. Boom, 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 boom. Another 1,000. Nice and easy. Nice and easy. Dan could probably use a sausage. You know Dan's all about that sausage. Come here. Yeah, so I think when he does get wounded, then you have to heal him before you can get back into battle. We'll have to test that, though. But I think we can go ahead and end this off here, actually. That's actually... Shoot. Today was a really good episode. We not only finished off the campaign, finished off story mode once and for all, but we went ahead and took out a town. Like, we just got a town. Like, not a castle, a town, with losing relatively low troops. So we only lost, like, 4 troops or something like that. Oh, no, we lost a few more in the siege. We only lost 4 taking out the Lord. We're in a good spot right now. We're in a really good spot. So hopefully in these next couple episodes, if we can kind of get our, I guess our faction might be a little busy with the Kingdom of Northumber, but if we can get, like, a campaign going over here, they've only got 2 real, castles left, I believe? I believe there's 2 of them. I think it's this one and this one. I'm not sure. I think we can finish off this faction altogether. And then it'll only be a one-front war against the Kingdom of Northumber, which I think is a little weakened right now. So, anyways, as always, guys, leave some comments down below. Let me know what you think about this series and all the rest of the series that we got going on right now. And as always, take it easy, guys.